Disclaimer, the following clips used in this video are all owned by Cartoon Network, and is used under fair use for the purposes such as criticism, comment, news reporting, teaching, scholarship, and research. Thank you for listening, and please don't copyright me, Cartoon Network. Also, spoiler alert. If you've ever seen an episode of Steven Universe, then you've basically seen this movie. But the only difference is this movie actually has a good villain. Now, in this movie, we finally confirm that Pink Diamond is Satan, and Spinel is the only good Steven Universe villain.
Allow me to clarify. In the Steven Universe movie, there is a new Cuphead character named Spinel. She's introduced as Pink Diamond's lovable jester of sorts. She became evil after Pink Diamond abandoned her on a garden planet for 6,000 years. After seeing a broadcast of Steven from Homeworld, confirming that not only has Pink Diamond moved on, but has also taken the form of Steven Universe, she decides to seek revenge and destroy Earth. Agent Ryan?
Why'd you say it like that?
I don't know, it just kind of felt right.
But not only does the movie have a pretty good villain, it also has a pretty good plot.
Allow me to clip.
So yeah, in this movie we found out that Steve Boy Bob Man has brought peace and love to the entire friggin' galaxy. And how do we find out this information? Through a storybook, of course. Then after that, we see Steven broadcasting to a whole bunch of planets and different gems. Heck, one might be Spookamagookums. Then after the nice little broadcast, we see the diamonds being a lot more smothering than I remember. But they do get some good lines, so I can't complain.
I've been saying please and thank you even to lower life forms.
What did we talk about?
Equal life forms.
Then after that song and dance, literally, we head over to Earth where we get a nice little song that's basically like a recap of the series. Because if I'm watching this movie, I definitely don't know the plot of Steven Universe. Also, this is kind of a nitpick, and I know movies got a movie, but if this is realistic, they wouldn't be, say, here we are in the future, because then in universe, they'd have to know there was a time jump. And that's dumb. But in all honesty, this is a pretty good song, and it gives us a basic idea of what's been happening on Beach City for the past 2 years. It also introduces us to our three main characters, Garnet, Amethyst, Hand Pearl, and Spookamagookums. Yeah, she kinda just comes out of nowhere like, yo, what's up, Home Slice, Bread Slice, I'm here to kill your Earth. Now, of course, this doesn't tickle the fancy of Stefan Galaxy, so he tries to reason with Spookamagookums. It goes as well as you expect.
I've had your little message to the universe.
Then after probably one of the coolest looking fight scenes in the entire series, Spookamagookum uses this cool scythe thing and just poofs the gems. But though we've seen these guys poofed multiple times with the series, heck, there's an entire episode dedicated to Amethyst being poofed, I don't think we've ever seen them poofed in such a graphic way before. I mean, sure, yeah, we've seen them been stabbed, electrified, friggin' just crunched, but I don't think we've ever seen them just been sliced in half. Woo, boy! But thankfully, the same thing doesn't happen to Steve Boy Bob Man, who kind of just takes it like a pro, and then poofs Spookamagookums right there.
If I could begin to be...
So you're probably thinking, psh, what's the big deal? I mean, they're just gonna reform what they always do. And in this matter, you would be correct.
See? Here she comes! Good old Pearl!
Holy crap! It's Pearl's new clamp form! Yes! No, in actuality, that scythe thing actually reverted them to their original settings, I guess you could say. Basically, they have no recollection of what happened with Steven, or Rose Quartz, or basically any memories. They just know their jobs. Heck, Amethyst doesn't even know words or basic movements. She actually just copies what people say and look like. It actually kind of gives us a nice reason why she shapeshifts so much. So after all this, you can probably guess what happens to Spookamagoogle memes.
I'm so excited to meet you!
You're not mad?
Mad? Why would I be mad at my best friend?
This will be fun. Aren't you the lucky one? Her cut is perfect and she's pink as well. She'll bring you endless entertainment. Your new best friend, Spinel.
Spinel, as we learn her name, is reverts to her first Cuphead boss phase, and she for some reason calls Steven her best friend. Yep, if someone stabbed me in the scythe, I too would call them my best friend. Heck, that's how I met Nick. So now it's a race against the clock for Steven to stop the drill, get his friends back to normal, and save Beach City and the world before it is destroyed. Sounds like a basic Tuesday night for Steven Universe. Now, since I've given you a basic rundown of the plot, let's get into the cons of the movie.
And there are a lot of them. Alright, let's start off. Let's talk about what they did with Connie. Now, Connie is a great love interest for Steven, because she completes Steven. She is the consciousness that Steven never had or rarely uses. She helps Steven through his problems and vice versa. And through the series, they develop a really good relationship, and in my opinion, the only real structured relationship of the series that isn't already previously established. So, what do you do with a character that important? Throw her in the trash! Now, I'm not saying they completely threw away her character. I mean, she is in some of the movie, just like barely any. Heck, Greg has more screen time, and he's in barely any of the ending credits. Hashtag Greg deserves better. This is sadly the same for a lot of characters, such as the new Crystal Gems, which I thought were going to play a way bigger role, but...
Nope. If you wanted to see community-requested things, this is not the movie for you. Jasper Redemption Arc? Nope. Lapidot Fusion? Nope. Steven Connie kiss scene? No. Well, kinda. They had the cheek thing, but that doesn't really count, so... Nope!
What we did have was the four-armed wonder himself, Grievan! He's twice as cool as both Greg and Steven combined, which isn't very cool at all. And even though they're both chubby man-children, they have the abs of Dwayne Johnson on steroids.
The Steven and Greg fusion was fine, but I feel like it could have been introduced better.
Also, Pearl is so obsessed with the pronoun game, she basically adds like 30 more minutes to this movie just because she doesn't say Spinell's name or who she is. Also, it's not like they didn't have time to say it or Steven didn't ask, because literally in this clip, he does!
It really is her, but she can't be serious.
You know her, Pearl? Can you tell us who she is?
Yeah, Pearl. Why don't you tell us about this new gem we've never met before? You gonna tell us? Yeah, you gonna tell us? You wanna tell us? Also, we never find out where that drill comes from, so yeah. But with all those cons out of the way, let's talk about the pros. The biggest pro, in my opinion, is that this movie looks phenomenal. The animation is gorgeous, the visuals are really nice, and Spinell has some of the best animations in the movie. Also, they somehow made a character whose main color palette is pink to be the most threatening villain of the series. And she has probably the coolest weapon of all time. I mean, oh my god, that's friggin' amazing. Basically, Spinell's like the best character. Alright, moving on. Also, there are some really good sight gags and jokes in this movie. But that's just our personal opinion. I mean, me and Nick do have like the worst sense of humor as possible.
What? Fight me, Ryan.
Also, the song Other Friends is, in my opinion, the best and kind of only good song in this movie. I love this song because it has a really good electric swing vibe to it, and the animation for this scene really goes with the song really well. Also, it's confirmed that if you sing while fighting, you will win. Also, this is kind of an after edit, but listening back to the songs, I'm completely wrong in this statement. There's two songs I really like, Drift Away, which is... and No Matter What, which I really recommend listening on YouTube. It's really good. Alright, back to the review. And I do have to admit, the true kind of love is good, you know, when it's not in this movie. Anyway, the Steven Universe movie is a lot like the show is based off of, and what I mean by that is, yes, though it has problems, some bigger than others, it's still extremely enjoyable and a movie that I find myself watching a lot of my free time. It has great animation, great characters, and, as always, great songs. Though some aren't bangers like in the show, there are enjoyable ones that, at first, might not seem like the best, but will definitely grow on you over time. It definitely does feel like this year's been pretty good when it comes to TV show movies. If it's been Invader Zim, Enter the Florpus, or Rocko's Modern Life, or... that's pretty much it. And with the Phineas and Ferb movie coming out next year, I can say that the quality of these movies aren't going down anytime soon. So yeah, even though this movie has problems, I'd give it a pretty good 9 out of 10.
But there was a scene where Steven's star on his shirt disappeared for like... 3 seconds, 0 to 10 movie.